When I think of the ways players get drafted to the NBA, the options that come to mind include college basketball, the G League, or overseas. You know, basically the traditional options we see nowadays. But what if I told you the player we're talking about today took none of these options? Former high school basketball phenom Kyree Walker, who probably needs no introduction, chose against the NCAA and pro options to instead completely sit out for a year and work on his game with pro trainers. And technically, he hasn't played any sort of organized basketball in 2 whole years. So it's really interesting that there's even a chance for him to get drafted, especially because of his initial rise in popularity. Listen, everyone who's watched basketball channels like Ball Is Life and more a few years back knows about the many viral and pretty entertaining videos featuring Kyree Walker and none other than Julian Newman. They racked up millions upon millions of views together, and these mixtape channels showed them off so much as if they were seemingly the best in the world for their age groups, even though we all know that wasn't the case. And because of all that media, Julian received so much hate back then and still does to this day. But he wasn't alone. I mean, the title looks harsh, but on social media, Kyree Walker was definitely treated as a joke, with people saying he's a grown man playing kids in middle school and that he was in high school for 7+ years. You're definitely lying if you say you've never seen these comments in reference to Kyrie. But now he's in position to achieve the dream of getting drafted, and it's really interesting. So today I want to briefly go over his journey and what kind of prospect he is, what value he really provides. But really quick before I move on, what's up YouTube, Plug Speaks, back with a vid. If you're new, first of all, welcome, go ahead and sub, also like the vid if you enjoy. I upload 3 to 4 times a week and we're grinding for 5k, so I'd for sure appreciate it. Also getting really close to 4k, but back to the vid though. So before I even speak on his high school career, let me bring up the legitimacy to his NBA draft stock. It's not like Kyrie heard from one team and decided to try his luck at making the NBA. Nah, he's gotten pre-draft workout opportunities from the Orlando Magic, Detroit Pistons, LA Clippers, Houston Rockets, and maybe even some others he's yet to make public. So yeah, there's definitely some draft buzz around Kyrie. But now for a quick summary. Around his freshman and sophomore season, ESPN had him listed as a 5-star recruit, which goes to show that regardless of all the clowning and jokes, his chances at being an NBA prospect have been real for a while. Now, as a sophomore, he played his first season for the well-known Hillcrest Prep, and he pretty much filled up the stat sheet. He averaged a huge 25 points, 8 rebounds, 8 assists, 2 steals, and 2 blocks. And I can't find where ESPN had him ranked that specific year, but I know he was regarded as one of the best players in the class of 2020. With those averages at that school, how could you not? And then as a junior, he was even more dominant. Like, basically every single stat went up. He averaged 30 points, 11 rebounds, 6 assists, 3 steals, and 2 blocks in 24 games, which is absolutely dominant, like I said. I mean, there's no way to hear of these accomplishments and think the man has no NBA talent. And during that great junior season, ESPN ranked him at 13th overall for his class. So clearly, he was at a great point in his high school career, some would say the peak. But the events during and following that junior year is really where everything went wrong. Because his mom battled cancer, a very unfortunate sickness, and then an elderly family member also passed away. Just a very unfortunate sequence of events. And after further thought on his future and desire to go pro, he eventually chose to completely sit out his senior year to instead train, which I imagine was a really tough decision. I mean, just think about it. You're regarded as one of the best in the class. You're performing well at one of the best high school basketball programs in the entire nation. And then boom, a lot of things happen that you can't even control. personal issues, ESPN drops your rank from a 5 to a 4-star recruit, and your final year before officially graduating will be spent playing versus zero organized teams. Like I said, it couldn't have been an easy choice to make. And I don't know what type of training or workouts he did, but this isn't debatable. It's for sure a disadvantage to miss out on 2 years of real game action while your peers play in the NCAA or a minor pro level like the G League. It's really not comparable. However, I will say that at the end of the day, before leaving high school, Kyree was playing at a level that seemed bound to make the NBA. We already went over what he did at Hillcrest Prep, and regardless of all the jokes, there's a reason teams are giving the man pre-draft opportunities without seeing him play for 2 years. It's pretty simple, they believe he's got NBA talent. So at this point in the video, I'ma briefly go over what I consider to be his strengths and weaknesses, and pretty much his overall value. Now, Kyrie's top moments at Hillcrest Prep often came in the form of scoring, and his ability to put points on the board is easily one of his best attributes. He showed an ability to score in both dominant and skillful ways, all while seemingly doing it efficiently. And obviously, we should take his play somewhat with a grain of salt, since it was against high school players far from the NCAA or the G League. But still, Kyrie has definitely shown some nice shot creation skills, some explosive drives for dunks, and overall an ability to score at a high level. And that's something that makes you really valuable as a prospect, especially if you can keep it going against NBA level defense. So Kyrie's for sure appealing in that aspect. And then on top of that, given his size and athleticism, I don't think it's crazy to believe Kyrie has the potential to be a very well-rounded player. When he left high school, he was reported at 6'5 with a 6'6 wingspan, and now most draft sites report that he's 6'6 to 6'7 while his wingspan is unknown. But it's fair to assume his wingspan is slightly longer than his overall height, which means Kyrie could very well become a solid threat as a two-way player, whether he plays shooting guard or small forward. And again, I don't want to rely on what he did versus high school competition, but his defense wasn't poor. Some of the blocks he got required some real effort, looking like Zion Williamson. Listen, Kyrie was a 5-star recruit for a reason. And of course, like any player, he's got his weaknesses. He's not a great passer, his shooting efficiency hasn't really been tested versus comp in 2 years. Same thing for basketball IQ. But overall, I believe he's worth GMs taking a chance on him somewhere late in the second round. Because on top of everything I've gone over, the pro training and more, Kyrie sort of got a co-sign from retired NBA star Gilbert Arenas, who said he doesn't need college to go pro when he went on his podcast. So yeah, there's plenty of reasons to believe, and me personally, I think it's all about opportunity. You give Kyrie that, and he might just surprise a lot of people. But anyways, that's about it for the vid. Let me know in the comments whether or not you see Kyrie getting drafted, why or why not. And yeah, I appreciate y'all watching as always. Like the sub, share it, sub if new, all of that, and I'm out.